This new feature 2024 tutorial video will teach you how to import and animate Sketchup model to Fuzor. In 2024, Fuzor will already automatically dismantle your Sketchup model for you. Therefore, the workflow is much easier. The first objective of this tutorial video is to import a Sketchup model such as an excavator. Second is to create a selection set for different parts. Third is to animate the excavator. So first step, let's drag this excavator Sketchup model. Then the load options will appear. Select specific coordinate. Then let's click on the area where we want to put the excavator. So the coordinates will appear, then click OK. Right click. To move the excavator, we can go to GIS. Click excavator, then move. Drag the arrow to move the model. Now in 2024, there is no need to click dismantle in element properties. For the second objective, create selection sets for the different parts. Go to more options. Search for selection sets. First, let's create a selection set for the main part. Click here, then click create. Rename it. Click again, then click explode group. So we want to separate the arms. Click explode group again. Then create a selection set for the arm and the bucket. Hold control, then select. Click create, then rename it. Next is to create a selection set for the bucket. Click create. For the last selection set, click the boom here, click create, and rename it, then click finish. For the third objective, let's animate the excavator. First, drag this to the right side. Then in more options, search for sequence animation. First step, click main in selection sets, then click create and insert keyframe. So for the second keyframe, we want to rotate this main to the left. So now click center pivot, and we can still adjust the center pivot by clicking on adjust pivot and unselecting the center pivot. Drag the arrow, disable adjust pivot. Select the rotate tool, then rotate the y-axis. Next to animate is the arm and bucket. Click insert keyframe. Enable center pivot. Click the rotate tool, then drag the z-axis. Also adjust the move tool and move it a bit up. Then click finish. We also need to move the boom, so click boom. Click the rotate tool and adjust the z-axis and also move it down. Click finish. Then for the last keyframe, let's move the bucket, insert keyframe, then enable adjust pivot, disable center pivot, and select the move tool to move it here. Then disable adjust pivot and select the rotate tool, drag the z-axis. Then click finish. Play the animation, and here is the result. Thank you for watching the video.